As designers, our life is spent bending vectors, right? And pushing pixels around. This makes the former really easy, bending those vectors. It's actually called Project Good Bones, and here we have Vineet Batra to show it to us. Welcome, Vineet.
Thank you, Paul. As designers, you create some truly amazing art. But the underlying geometry of such vector graphics is generally complex. And as you can imagine, editing these can be quite painful at times. For example, my dino here is not looking where he's headed to. And that may not be a good idea. Now, if I do want him to look straight ahead, I have to select and modify a whole bunch of paths. And believe me, this is not an easy thing to do. Well, this is where Project Good Bones comes in. It helps you modify complex vector graphics naturally using shape-aware deformation. I can create connected bone handles and create a skeleton-like structure. Now, once we have created the skeleton for our dino here, I can simply move the handle around, and it modifies all my underlying curves. And now, making our dino look straight ahead is as easy as this. And good, we did that, because this T-Rex here is waiting for him. Now, maybe the big fellow is excited to see his new friend and wants to say hello. Now, to make him move, do I need to create a skeleton for him as well? Not really. Good Bones can take care of this, and all we need to do is turn on this default. Now, when I click on an object, it analyzes the shape of my graphic and automatically creates a skeleton.
Wow.
That means we can start playing right away. Our big fellow wags his tail to show his excitement and opens his mouth just to say hello. He is really expressive. Good Bones is not just limited to dinos. It works well for humans as well. Imagine you have spent hours creating this art for an event invite, and just when you think you are done, your boss tells you it lacks spark. And to him, it looks like a case of bad breath. Wow. Let's see if we can quickly add some spark to it. We bring our couple closer.
Oh, yeah.
Bend their heads.
Yeah.
Move the bodies closer. And just adjust the posture a bit. And now, it looks like they're in love.
Yeah.
Yeah, they do.
Here's before and after for you. But knowing my boss, he's not going to be happy with just one option. So I created a few more for him to choose from.
Wow.
Nice.
And all this without adding any complexity. The number of curves and anchor points remains exactly the same. OK, so now my boss is happy. Let's have some fun. Here, Annie and Troy have run into dangerous claw hands on their mission to Moon. And it looks like a battle is looming. Now, as soon as claw hand senses danger, his antennae go up. And he moves in to attack Troy. He brings down his crusher and tries to grab him. Little Troy also gets ready for the attack, and he aims his gun at claw hands. But it's clear that he could use some help. And like a true friend, Annie jumps into the action, extends her robotic arm to block claw hands, and saves the day. And in just a few seconds, we have created a new scene in Adventures of Annie and Troy. And remember, All this is complex vector graphics. But what? Thank you. But what's even better is that good bones remembers where we started from. So we can easily interpolate between these and get new poses. I can select any pose.
It's animating.
Wow. Talk about saving some time.
We can also combine these poses to create a GIF, like this, which I created on backstage.
What?
Thank you.
Thank you, Vineet. Fantastic.
Great
Project
job.
Good Bones.